Hi there, my primary to grade one tappers. How are you? I hope you've had a great Easter and I hope that you're all staying well and safe. We miss you terribly. And what we've done for you this term, seeing as we can't come back to our live classes just yet, is we've planned a lovely new tap class for you that incorporates all of the steps that you need for your primary grade and teaches you just a few little nuggets from grade one as well. Just something for you to have a little go at home. Okay, so just give it a crack. Hopefully you'll enjoy all the new music and the new combinations. Today I'm going to be a little bit talky because I'm going to have to explain all the exercises to you. But when you do this class every week, it should get a bit faster for you to do. So you can just forward wind the bits where I'm talking and you go, oh, I know this now, I just need to put the music on and have a go. And the other beautiful thing about doing this on video is if you need to have another practice of an exercise, you can just rewind it and go, oh, I'm going to just do that one again. Didn't quite get those feet there. Okay, so you've got plenty of ways you can work with this at home, and grown-ups, all of your support is much appreciated. If I'm giving some little teaching points about arms or posture or anything, or what the sound should be, then it'd be great if you could pick that up with your children. Excuse the tap-related pun there. So let's get going, shall we, everybody? I know who I'm talking to, don't I? I'm talking to Annika, Lucy, Jocelyn, Bethany, Maybell. I'm talking to Lottie. I'm talking to Leah. Who else am I talking to? I'm talking to Libby. Yes, I'm talking to the people who are really secure with their primary. And Jaden, you're in this class too, so give it a crack. By all means at home, join in with Leah and you'll be great. Just have some fun with it, okay? And that's why I'm going to be doing a little bit of new stuff with you, because you're so good at your primary. However, you do need to keep those basic steps ticking over. Right, Kate's going to shush now. I'm going to get on with your warm-up. It's fast, but you're very good at fast, neat footwork, team. So you're going to be just fine. On the introduction, let's just have a little bit of space between our feet, shall we? And just do some nice bounces in parallel, just with those arms swinging nice and straight. Past your legs, point forwards, knees spongy, heels down at the moment. Well done. Okay, now it's a zippy one, so just get ready. Side up position, you're going to do two straight and two quick straight taps. Straight tap, straight tap, straight tap, straight tap, close. Yes, just striking the ball of your foot. Let me show you from the side. The foot is off the floor, and I'm looking for you to use your ankles. Yes, four times, okay? Right, left, right, left. How is that? Easy peasy, fantastic. Good. Now then, after that, I want you to do for me, separate your feet slightly, lifting up the toes and doing some ball beats for me. Can you do that for me now? You're going to get your shins nice and warm doing that. Up and down, up and down. Bounce your knees, bounce your knees. Then try 8 quick ones like that. Then heels. 2, 3, 4. And then 8 quick ones. Well done, team. Now you're going to do a ball with the heel. Leaving them together. So just on the spot, you should be creasing your tap shoes across the arch and you should be pushing up into your instep and bending your knees. Let's get off the spot, shall we? 1, 2, 3, heels. If you were in the show last year, you did the step. Come with me. 1, 2, 3, heel. Brilliant, guys. That goes nice and that's quite quick, so keep it small. And then we're going to go straight into forward back taps. Nice, simple step. Quite challenging. Good. Only the ball of the foot remember. Fantastic. Well done. All over it. You are doing brilliantly. Obviously I'm going to do it with you, but I'm just giving you an idea of what's to come. Then you're going to bounce again just to catch your breath. And then we're going to do spring, 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 clap. Three and stop. 1, 2, 3, clap. 2, 3, clap. Try not to be holding your paper in your hands when you do this. Are you bringing your feet up behind you? Not in front of you. Your knees are in line. Good. 2, 3, clap. 1, 2, 3. Brilliant. We are basically going to do all those moves again, not necessarily in the same order. And then we're just going to do some silly motion of the oceans to the side. You might know this song, it's from Hairspray. Let's do it. Are you ready? Good. I can hear you say yes, so that's great news. Yeah. Here we go. no heels. Forward, cross and back and out. Forward, cross and back and out. Just four steps on the balls of your feet. Can you manage that? Of course you can. And again, four, three, two, one. Back one, back one, back one. Give me one shadow step. Forward, cross, back and out. Step, step, run and run. Woo! You can manage that, really. Right and left, down and run, run, run. Have you finished that with your left leg up, team? Into the right, into the left, right, left, right. Good. Right back with the left. Taking out the heels. So we're not doing step heel, step heel. We're just doing step, 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 because it's really quick. Come on, that's your challenge. Here we go with me. I'll back you again. Start with your right leg, girls. And don't worry, you'll get this. Okay. Woo! You're going to put your hands up. Are you ready? Final position, right there. Shuffle, shuffle. That one and do it again if you need to. Brilliant, there's a lot in there. But basically, that was a really good drill for your shuffles and ball changes. I just thought I'd make it a little bit more fun. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that one. Here's the next one. Okay, so we're going to try adding something to a tap step. Come on, do some tap steps for me. Tap step, tap step, tap step, tap step. Two sounds, not the kick out. Bring it from the back. Come on, monkeys. And two, and three, and four. Are you staying on the balls of your feet? Are they grown-ups? Are they staying there? And one, and two, and three, and four. You've got to get those toes up for me. Well done. So you can do tap steps, yes? Fabulous. Show me something so simple from pre-primary that you've just done in the warm-up. Fall on heel. Step on heel, yes? Fall on heel. Fall on heel. Good. So those two steps together make something called a tap step heel. And you need that for grade one. For grade one, come with me. Three sounds, I'll show you from the side. Forward tap, onto the ball, and your heel. Let's try that on the other leg. Forward tap, can you see how my toes are up, but my knees relaxed, good. Onto the ball, use your instep, push, 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 and tap step, heel, tap, tap, tap. Make sure you're trying to make three sounds. Well done, primary. Grade one, guys. Parents, just encourage you on this. This is brilliant learning. I wish I could see them doing it. Feel free to send me a video, please, of them trying these things. Tap step, heel. I can give feedback on the videos. Tap, tap, tap. Yes. So, let's rewind and let me show you what I want you to do with the actual exercise. So, what I want you to do first, team, is four tap steps that you know from your primary grade. So if I just back you going slightly up to the corner, you'll get my right leg first. Tap, step, step, tap, step, tap, step. Then just try two of those tap, step, heels for me. Tap, step, heel right, tap, step, heel right. Listen to that rhythm. And five, six, and seven, eight. Why would I start with five there? Because your first four are your tap one, and two, and three, and four. Tap, step, heel, tap, step, heel. How was that? Okay? Good try. Tap step heels, a new thing for you. So do it wherever you can. Okay? And we're just going to do that today. We're just going to do that all around wherever you've got to work in today.
Thank you.
because we haven't done it for a while. It actually isn't as fast as it might seem because you're learning loads of new things today. So don't worry, just keep working on it. Yes? Actually, that tap, spring, tap, spring, tap, step, ball, change is about as fast as you do it in your exam. So that's really good practice for tempo, all right? And a bit more jazzy. Okay, did you like that one? So you practice a little bit there. Toe taps, we have come across, but you don't need them in your primary exam, but you will need them in grade one. So just make sure, grown-ups, that they're stretching their foot fully. And once you strike the floor, you bring the foot off for a tap. So it's got that sound resonating. Boom. Oh, missed that one. Yes, bring it off. Great. Again, rewind to do that one again if you need to, my lovelies. Right, let's get back to your shuffle steps. Guys, I'm just going to do a set exercise from primary because it's always one that you go, oh, this one. Okay, and it's not difficult, it's just the patterning, isn't it? You don't know what I'm talking about yet, so I'll tell you. Shuffle, step, shuffle, step, shuffle, step, shuffle, ball change. You all can do it. You all can do a shuffle step, and you all can do a shuffle ball change. The thing is the counting. You've got to remember, I've done three, the fourth one goes back. Okay? And then you should have your left leg ready to start the whole thing again. Shuffle, step, shuffle, step, shuffle, step. I've done three. Here comes my right leg. Shuffle, ball, change. And take that to the flat because it's like the end of a sentence, isn't it? Shuffle, ball, change. Again with me, come on. Shuffle, step, shuffle, step, shuffle, step. And take it back and bring it in, and bring it in, and bring it in, and take it back. So the fourth shuffle must come back. And hey presto, you're there for the ball change. Sometimes we change legs, don't we, on that one, cheekies? I'm going to back you. Do it again with me with no music. Ready? Right leg, off we go. And then do it with mum and dad. Come on, take it back, left. Use the left, use the right, use the left, take the right back. 3, 2, 1, and go. 3, comes in, 2, comes in, 1, then go back. Okay, it just needs drilling, so let's do it with some music. Different music. Alright, it's going to come straight in quite quickly.
Yeah!
Carpet. That's called a chug, 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 chug. Okay? So in grade one, you are going to learn this step and you're going to do it like this. Step to the side on the demi point, on the balls of your feet in other words, so the legs are actually pretty straight. So this is where your ballet balance will come in really handy. Pull those tummies in, tug down. Into those legs, bend your knees, soften those knees. To the left, up, up, good. Step together, jump, keep going. Step together, jump, good job. Step together, jump. Right, light, jump and down. Right, light, jump and down. I do want to try and get you to find one sound there, not one foot at a time. Just one clean push, chug. You've learned a chug, okay? Hands on your hips, we're gonna do three, sides. And then paradiddle back. Ooh, cheeky. Remember your paradiddles, guys. Heel out, heel dig. Smack your pick up. Ball dig next to the other foot. Land your heel and a tap. And then you're nice and low to come up onto the balls again. Okay, next tug. Two. Well done. Three. You've gone to the left, so use your left leg for the chug. Again, heel pick up, heel back. Well done, that's a tricky exercise, but I think I'm going to enjoy just giving it a go with the music. Here we go.
Green light, go. That's all I know.
Wait, I like this. So I think you like two. Hands on your hips, go to your right. Step in there. It's a chug, isn't it? Yeah? Just remember to bend your knees and use your tummy. What we don't want is a sort of a jolting feeling. You'll feel it in your knees, you'll feel it in your back. Just try and control it, yes? That's the reason why we don't do that one until grade one, but you're all strong enough now to give that one a go. Chug. Well done on your chugs. If you want to rewind it, do it again, guys. Yes, you by all means rewind it. I'm going to push on with your class. You are doing amazing. Right, stamp, brush, hop, step, ball change, stamp, brush, hop, step, ball change, stamp, brush, hop, step, ball change, step, step, step. Got that? Stamp, brush, hop, step, ball change. Now you're on the other leg, da, 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 little light steps. Yes, fabulous. Then, because it's the other travelling step that you do in primary, let's just bez out. Tap spring, tap spring, tap step, ball change, tap spring, tap spring, tap step, ball change, tap spring, tap spring, tap step, ball change. Just at the end, okay? Just to give you a little bit of a drill. So this one's a bit of a drill. Yes, nothing too brain taxing. Just I'm combining your two ending steps into one exercise. Here we go with a bit of Oliver for you. Start on your right leg with your first leg. Solved it just before we stopped classes. So remember, Your taps need to come from the back and not get too big and out of your control. So don't make it too big, and that might really help, okay? Other problem, could you hear your heels? Yes, if your heels were catching, what might be the problem with your posture? Yeah, just get that weight shifted forward slightly more and stay up on the balls of your feet. It will really help, just that little tiny shift, okay? Great things to think about there if you want to do that exercise again. How you doing? You're nearly there. Really good first class. So much learning done today. You are incredible. Well done. Now then, how much time have I got? Oh, we're doing all right. We're doing good. So, a nice little shuffle, we'll change shuffle, hop step practice. But I've just made it a little bit jazzy for you because I know how much you like that. So we're going to do right leg first. I'm going to mirror you actually because you're good at these. Shuffle, and change, taking it back. Shuffle, hop step. Now on the left. Shuffle, and change, shuffle, hop step. Three times in total. So give me another one on the right. Shuffle, and change, shuffle, hop step. Guys, you've just put your right leg down, haven't you? So which leg is free? The left. Give me a little drag out to the side. Lovely. Okay. What leg is free? Well, here's the thing. We're going to drag and we're going to close. You've got plenty of music there. You're going to drag and you're going to close. So that you do have the left leg to start again. Shuffle, we'll change, shuffle, up step. And there we go on the right leg. On the left. And back to the right and close. And I can hear that. You don't need to apologise for the sound you're going to make. You've got tap shoes on. So put it down with a bit of a sound, just a step. And we're going again. Shuffle, back, front, and lift it up. And take. Possible. Don't worry if not, but are you hearing a clean shuffle before a ball came, and are you hearing a clean shuffle before hop step? That's what we're aiming for long term, okay? Lovely jazz hands, I saw them, I could see them, I could feel them. So well done on that one. Do that again if you need a bit more practice, because you know in primary, guys, your shuffle ball change, shuffle hop step is a set exercise. Right then, time check. Oh, great. Have you had some water? Do you need some? Grab some if you need some. We've got a really nice little step now. You've probably done it with me, but it's actually, again, another one that's in grade one. And it's a heel and ball. Heel and ball. Heel and ball. Now, you might think that's easier than ball to heel, but it's actually about where the weight is. So you've got to stay back on the dig and then transfer on the ball. Heel and ball and heel and ball. So it's great that you're getting a bit of a head start on the heel and ball. You're going to do three, and then you're going to step behind and to the side. So I'm just going to show you that from the back view. Let's go with our right leg, guys. Heel ball right, heel ball left, heel ball right. So you've transferred your weight. Which leg is free? That's right, the left. Step behind, step out to the side. That's it, just behind and aside. Two steps, guys, two steps. So we just go heel and ball, heel and ball, heel and ball behind side. Now if you've put your weight down, you should have your left leg ready. Are you ready on the left? Good. Heel and ball, heel and ball, heel and ball behind side. Lovely. And again. Heel and ball, heel and ball, heel and ball behind side. Left and right, left behind side. All right. Well done. Now then, you might have noticed I ended up on the wall there. So it's quite tricky if you're just going forwards. It's also a little bit dull. Should we do something more interesting with the patterning there? Yes, lovely. So I'm going to give you a suggestion, and then you're going to see if you can make it even more interesting, okay? A bit like your diagonal tap step and changes, which we haven't even done today because they're so good I didn't even bother doing them. We're going to do heel ball right, heel ball left. Heel ball right, step behind and side to change to your other corner. It might be the corners of your kitchen, your dining room, your living room, I don't know, your hallway. But find two little corners as your points of reference there. So now I come back on my left. Heel and ball, heel and ball, heel and ball, step behind and side. Just two steps, step, step. Back again to the other corner. Boom. Are you with me too? Three, behind and side, left. Two, three, behind and side, great. Do that with me first, and it's nice and slow. We're gonna just chill it right out. Diagonal pathway there. What else can did you do with that step? Could you just take it round in a circle? Yeah? Boom, boom, boom. Keep going forward. Boom, boom, boom. Keep going forward for 2 seconds, yes? That's one option for you. Go round in a circle and just keep stepping forward on your steps. Could you be super clever and come forward, 2, 3, and turn around your back? 2, 3, and turn around your forward. 2, 3, and turn around. I'm changing which way I'm turning. I'm thinking, how does it feel? I think I'm going to go that way. Oh, how is it going to feel this way? I'm going to go that way. Yes, so there's another thing you could do then. Right, take a minute. Let's be a bit creative. Woo! Give me those creative juices through the screen, please, guys. Are you going to take my pattern on the diagonal with this step? Are you going to go around in a circle? Are you going to come forwards and then do a U-E and come back? Or, I mean, I'm sure there's many other patterns you could do with this step. What could you do with it? Have a think. Are you deciding? Maybe have a chat with your grown-ups or your brothers and sisters if they're joining in as well. What are we going to do? I've given you 3 options. You can just steal one of mine if you like. Okay, are you ready? Your turn to show me. By all means, post your videos in, parents. I'd love to see what they've come up with on this one. Yes? I'm gonna mix it up, I'm not gonna come out, but I am gonna use my right leg first. Lot of new learning, so well done. We are going to leave it there, and I'm going to ask you to take your bow, and then next week what I'd like you to do on top of doing this class at home, I'd like you to look for the next video on our YouTube channel, get your grown-ups to help you find the add-on for primary to grade one tap and do that bit as well. And it will be a little bit of a detail of the business of love dance. All right, and it might be something else as well, a little bit of a sequence for you. So there'll be a bit more. Now you might think, well, that's a lot of tap to do. It'll be an hour if I add on 10, 15 minutes. But if you don't have to listen to me explaining all the exercises like you did today, just forward wind the odd bit and you'll be able to do this class a little quicker. I hope that makes sense, parents. Yes, so the idea is they're picking up the speed on this class because they'll know it better. Every time they do it, they'll know it a bit better. Yes, it shouldn't end up being too quick though, but then you'll have time for the add-ons as well, because we want to keep your brains ticking over this term, guys, yes? And learning sequences is a very good way of doing that. Brilliant work! Let's take your bow. Oh, I miss you. So weird not seeing you. Ready, team? To the right first, guys. Open that up, lift it up over here. There we go. Big presentation here. Done. Remember, it's the last opportunity you've got to make an impression on your examiner or your audience. Well done! Good job! Okay, don't forget to tune in again next week and learn some more from us. Keep tapping! Lots of love. Bye!